Hello and welcome to Omega Study Online. In this video, we are going to discuss about most important topic of class 12 physics, that is magnetic field at the center of circular loop carrying current. So we have to find out the magnetic field at the center of this circular coil. So let us assume this is the circular coil whose total length is L. Since this coil is in the form of circular loop, so its total length equal to perimeter of circle. So its total length always equal to L is equal to 2 pi r if r is the radius of this coil. And let us assume current I is flowing in the coil. So due to this current, we have to find out the magnetic field at the center of this coil. So let us assume this is the small part of this wire. Total length of wire is L and small part of this coil is DL. Yeah, here we can say that small length of this coil is DL, and due to this DL, because this DL is known as current element, and due to this small DL, we have to find out the magnetic field at the center of the coil, that is point P. Now in this question, basically we have to find out the magnetic field due to whole wire, but first we find out the magnetic field only due to this small element, that is current element at point P. Then we integrate the equation, then we can find out the magnetic field due to whole wire. So this is the current element, and these two I into DL, these two produce magnetic field at point P. So let's first start. Basically, this is the application of Bio-Savart law. So we use Bio-Savart law. तो क्या करेंगे अपन, देखिए first यहाँ पर क्या होगा, magnetic field at P due to I into DL. Magnetic field at point P due to I into DL by Bio-Savart law. So by Bio-Savart law, we have already studied that magnetic field is given by dB is equal to mu naught 4 pi into I DL sin theta by R square. This is the equation number 1. So this is come from Bio-Savart law. And here let us assume this is the angle theta, and this theta always equal to 90 degree for circular coil, because in a circular figure radius is always perpendicular to its perimeter. जो आपका radius होगा वो perimeter पर क्या होगा, perpendicular होगा. तो this theta is equal to 90 degree. So what happen then, since theta is equal to 90 degree, so dB is equal to mu naught by 4 pi into I DL, only DL, R square, because sin 90 degree is equal to 1, so our equation will be mu naught 4 pi into I DL by R square. So this is the magnetic field, produced by this small length of the wire, or we can say that this is the magnetic field produced by this small length of coil. But we have to find out the magnetic field due to whole wire, or we can say that whole coil. So we have to integrate this equation with respect to length. So dB is the B. dB is the B. B means magnetic field. dB is the magnetic field due to dl. DB is the magnetic field due to dl. Now magnetic field due to coil or loop. Now magnetic field due to whole coil or loop L. Due to magnetic field due to whole coil or L means we have to find out the magnetic field due to whole wire. Again, for B is equal to integration of dB. Now put the value of dB. dB equal to mu naught 4 pi I dl by r square. Mu naught 4 pi into I dl by r square. If we observe in this equation carefully, then we find out that mu naught 4 pi is a constant. I is also constant because value of current will not change. And radius also constant because radius of the circular coil will not change. So what is the variable? Only length of this coil is variable, because first we find magnetic field due to this small length, then now we have to find out the magnetic field due to whole length, means dl to l. So only l is variable quantity and rest of them are constant quantity. So mu naught by 4 pi into I by r square, and this dl. And this dl is equal to, and what is dl? And this dl, and d, and solve this equation, mu naught by 4 pi into I by r square, and this dl. And what is dl? So dl is the length of this coil, and length of this coil is equal to perimeter of circular coil, so it's equal to 2 pi r. If you follow this equation, pi to pi cancel, 2, then 2. Then next step will be, after this equation, next step will be B is equal to mu naught into I and R, then square cut, then 2R. So this is the final magnetic field. This is the final magnetic field due to this circular coil in the center. So this is the magnetic field at the center of circular coil. This is the final derivation. Now we have to find out the some characteristics of this coil, means dependence. First dependence, if we talk about the dependence, then first it depend upon the, dekhiye, first B. B means magnetic field due to circular coil is always directly proportional to current of the coil. First magnetic field at the center of coil is directly proportional to current flowing in the coil. Means if increase the value of current, then B also increase. If decrease, then B also decrease. Now second, magnetic field at the center of this circular coil is equal to, if we assume this circular coil has n number of turns. ये जो coil आपका n number of turns से, मतलब इसमें जो number of turns है coil का, वो कितने बार बना हुआ है आपका, n times बना हुआ है. तो अपन क्या कर सकते हैं, यहां पर n. तो दिस इज द फाइनल इक्वेशन. इफ वी अज्यूम दैट दिस सर्कुलर कॉइल इज मेड ऑफ n नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स, देन वी कैन मल्टीप्लाई द n हियर. सो फॉर b डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू n, दिस इक्वेशन शोज दैट इफ नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स इन अ सर्कुलर कॉइल इज मोर, देन मैग्नेटिक फील्ड एट द सेंटर विल बी मोर. इफ नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स इज लेस, then magnetic field at the center always less. Now third dependence is b 1 by r. R means radius. If the radius of the circular coil, if radius of the circular coil is higher, then magnetic field will be lower. If radius of the circular coil is lower, then magnetic field will be higher. Because if increase the radius of this coil, then the distance between this point and this point increase, and due to increase in distance, magnetic field also decrease. So this is the third relation, and fourth relation is B directly proportional to mu naught. Mu naught means medium between this DL and P also change the magnetic field at the center. So magnetic field in the center of circular coil also depend upon the medium between this point to this point. If we put the some other material like paper, glass, then magnetic field also change. In this way, this topic is completed 100%. If you like my way of explanation, please subscribe my channel and share this video to your friends, and also press the bell icon so that you can never miss update related to physics online classes. तो चलिए अपने वीडियो यहीं पर एंड करते हैं, मिलेंगे नेक्स्ट वीडियो में।